Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. Today, I'm going to show you how to create this glossy transparent cover in Photoshop. During the process, we are going to replace the magazine content with our smart layer pages that you can use it to change the contents. Then after that, we'll create a transparent cover and add a nice glossiness using some cool brush strokes. So let's begin with the tutorial. Here is the image where we are going to do the adjustments. I have applied a mask to half portion of the magazine. So let me show you. This is how it looks after the masking. So let's delete the original image and begin with our designing process. Now the first thing we're going to do is to create a page and map it to our image. So using the rectangular selection tool, draw a rectangle, then add a new layer and fill it up with foreground color. We'll change the color to white using the color picker panel, then apply it using the shortcut Alt Backspace. Now convert the layer to smart object and let's map it to the image. First of all, activate the transform option using the shortcut Command or Control D and reduce the layer opacity to see the placement properly. Now right click and choose distort option. Set the points to each corner of the second page. Then choose Wrap option and maintain the flow of the pages using the handles. Click and drag to move the grid. Try to achieve the exact perspective according to the image. Increase the opacity if needed and try to get a proper alignment between the two lines. Once you're done with the adjustments, press Enter. Next, we'll create another rectangle to map the top image using the same steps. Keep the layer on top and set the corners using the distort option. Now using the wrap option, adjust the grid according to the perspective view of the image. Click and drag to set the middle region and handles for the edges. Once done, press Enter. Now following the same steps, we'll create one more rectangular page for our transparent cover. So using a distort option, we'll set the corner points little differently, like this. Now using the wrap option, let's set the perspective view. For this, we're going to give very little distance between two pages, but we'll increase the curve in the middle region to give more gap. This will help in adding drop shadow to give more realistic look. Now as we have completed creating the pages, let's add the contents. Now double click on the third layer to open the smart object file. Here we'll add the content. So let's bring in some text from our previous files. Scale up the size and to align them in a single line, select all the text and on top you can see all these options are activated. Click on the right alignment option to align them on the right side. Change the background to dark purple and save the files. You can see that the contents of the third page is now updated. Increase the opacity of the layer. Next, we'll add the content to our second layer. So double click to open the smart object. We'll use the alive cover as the content for this page. I have the file, so select the layers and drag and drop it to our smart object file. Scale on the size and place them properly. Now go to the file and save it. It's updated in our main file. Now let's edit our top page. Increase the opacity to full and double click to open the file. Here, change the background color to light gray and reduce the opacity to 21%. Now we'll bring in the title for the magazine. So we'll open our second page content and drag and drop the title to our transparent file. We'll set it around here. Next, we'll hide the title layers from the second page content so that it's not visible to our main file and save it. Now in our main file, we have all the pages with the contents. Next, we'll enhance our second page. So add brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Click on this icon to apply it only to the second page. We'll increase the contrast and reduce the brightness. Then we'll add hue and saturation adjustment layer and increase the saturation value. Next, create a duplicate of the transparent layer. We'll use the second layer to add drop shadow. So change the layer mode to subtract and start modifying the shape using the wrap option. Click and drag to drag down the shadow. We'll make sure that the corner shadows are closer to the title as compared to the middle region. Next, we'll add blur. So go to Filter, Blur Gallery, Tilt Shift. Set the direction diagonally and set the blur value around 17. Next, to show a little thickness to the transparent cover, click on the thumbnail to make a selection of the cover and add a new layer. Then reduce the fill value to 0%. Open Layer Style panel and apply Outer Glow. Increase the size to around 3 pixels and you can see a white border on the edges. Reduce the opacity to 67% and click OK. So we have added a slight thickness to the cover. Next, we'll add glossiness to the transparent cover. To add that, add a new layer. Choose a brush from the brush panel. We'll choose this dotted brush and draw a straight line from here till there. Now go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Set the blur value around 38 pixels and click OK. Now using the wrap option, adjust the position. This will add a nice shine to the cover. Next, we'll add more details. Add another new layer. This time, we'll reduce the size of the brush and draw out random lines. Then apply Gaussian Blur. These lines are acting as a light reflection. We'll draw out few more lines roughly and apply Gaussian Blur to it. Next, we'll add color patches. So select the brush, change the color to black, increase the size and draw a patch. You can rotate the angle of the brush under Brush Attributes panel. Then apply it on the surface. Then using wrap option, modify the shape according to our cover perspective. Then change the layer mode to overlay with the opacity around 28%. Now you can do further adjustments with the color, reflection, glossiness and shadow for final touch up. Finally, we have completed designing glossy transparent magazine cover. During the process, we have applied some cool techniques to create the pages and the contents. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.